Salma, 67-year-old homemaker, presents in clinic for routine visit. She has type 2 diabetes for 7 years. Okay, she's 67, right? I would not say old, but 67, okay? So type 2 diabetes will last 7 years. She lives alone, but attended by a maid in morning hours. She has limited mobility. She moves around in the home with a little difficulty. Maid comes in to her, comes in to assist her in the morning hours. No known hypertension or cerebrovascular disease, but she has dyslipidemia. So she has got diabetes and dyslipidemia, two things, right? Recently, she has had occasional low blood glucose episodes, okay? She walks 30 minutes every day and takes diet as advised, okay, good. She's on metformin 1000 milligram twice daily, glimepiride 1 milligram at breakfast, and atorvastatin 10 milligram once daily. Again, her body mass index is 22.7. Investigations show fasting plasma glucose of 111, a random blood glucose of 165, an A1C of 7, and I'll come whether it's control or uncontrolled, LDL 95, HDL 41, triglycerides 195, an EGFR of 59, and an ACR of 12, and an SGPT of 25. So let's move on to our first question. Now, what is the biggest problem in this case? Can anybody tell me? There are many factors that are coming at, right? Okay, write down whatever thing you think is important in this case. Just write down in the Q&A section. What seems to be important to you in this particular case? Hypoglycemia. Stop glimepiride. Fantastic professionals on board with me today. Fantastic. Chronic kidney disease as well. Yeah, she's dipping into chronic kidney disease, stage 3. Okay, so you all know she lives alone, she has hypoglycemia. Alayar, you're on spot, right? Prevent hypoglycemia. Fantastic. You know the real problem in this case is a hypoglycemic event. So what would be the target levels for HbA1c in this particular case? Yes, anybody. What would be the target for A1c? Write it down in the chat box, right? Write it down in the chat box. 7 to 7.5. Less than 7, Dr. Mazam says. Mujahid, 77.5. Noreen says 77.5. Asra, 77.5. Okay, it's coming pretty quickly. 77.5. Most of you are correct because hypoglycemia, you want an A1C that is a little higher. And again, if you can control it less than 7 without hypoglycemia, do it. It's up to you. Yes, you can do it. But particularly now when she has hypoglycemia, for the next 3 months, the target can be 7 to 7.5. Targets can be revised. जिंदगी में कभी कोई गोल होता है 10 साल बाद गोल कुछ और होता है सेम गोल्स विद डायबिटीज पेशेंट चेंजिंग गोल्स राइट विल यू लाइक टू मेक एनी चेंज ओके गोल इज 7 to 7.5 दिस लेडी ऑलरेडी हैज एन A1C ऑफ 7.0 वुड यू लाइक टू मेक एनी चेंज इन हर ट्रीटमेंट वुड यू लाइक टू चेंज हर ट्रीटमेंट यस और नो यस क्विक आंसर्स यस और नो यस यस ओके डॉक्टर एसएम सेज यस यस कामरान सेज यस ओके Anonymous says no, okay. So you would like to change it? Yes, the problem is hypoglycemia, right? So we have to change the treatment that is going on currently. So which of the following treatment change would you suggest for Mrs. Salma? Let me read all of these and then answer like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, right? So let me read all of these first for you. Stop sulfonylurea. Number 2, reduce sulfonylurea. Number 3, stop sulfonylurea and add SGLT2 inhibitor. Number 4, stop sulfonylurea and add DPP4 inhibitors. Number 5, stop sulfonylurea and add basal insulin. Number 4, stop oral medications and start premixed insulin twice daily. What do you guys say? What would you do in your practice in this particular patient? Okay, so people say 3. Okay, so 3. Stop SU and add SGLT2 inhibitor. Again, somebody says stop SU, add DPP4. Again, number 3, 3, 4, 3. Okay. So most of you have one answer. Stop sulfonylurea and add SGLT2 inhibitor or DPP4 inhibitor. To be honest, this was a tough question to ask to you all guys, right? So we know that we need a medication that doesn't have hypo in our age, right? Now, we have both options. DPP4, we have got an option of SGLT2 inhibitor. Which has least side effects? Now, if you ask me, DPP4 is very benign medication with hardly any side effects, right? This is a 67-year-old lady. Sometimes you're skeptical that she has a homemade coming in. How much movement does she have? What about if she gets a UTI? So if I have to pick one out of these two medications in this particular case, I would say go with DPP-4 inhibitor. But then you can argue, Dr. Ali, why don't you control cardiovascular risk? So let's move forward, and I'll tell you about that as well, right? So if you ask me, in this particular case, I would stop sulfonylurea and add a DPP-4 inhibitor on top of SGLT2 inhibitor. We don't want hypoglycemia, right? It causes cerebrovascular disease, cardiovascular disease straight away. Now look at this guideline. This is American Diabetes Association. I'll make it bigger. Now look at this very carefully. In atherosclerotic cardiovascular disease, yes, after metformin, SGLT2 inhibitor. Or high risk of atherosclerotic cardiovascular disease, again, metformin ke baad SGLT2 inhibitor. What is high risk? Anybody more than 55 years of age with diabetes with more than one risk factor is a high risk. This lady had diabetes and hypertension, only one additional risk factor, age is more than 55. She doesn't fall in this category where I have a compulsion to give SGLT2 inhibitor. So I would take the liberty and say, okay, let's give DPP-4, keep life simple so that this lady doesn't come back to me with some other problem, right? So SGLT2 inhibitors, although very safe, but again, DPP-4 inhibitors in the last 15 years, they have proven that they are very side effect free medications. And in this particular case, I would have gone with DPP-4 inhibitors, right? So again, what should be the LDL cholesterol target? Less than 160, less than 130, less than 100, less than 70, less than 55. Current LDL is 95. Remember that, right? Okay, so what do you guys write? Less than 70. Okay, less than 70, less than 55. Less than 100. Okay, so again, varied answers. Now go back to that slide. This is a beautiful slide. If somebody wants, just email me and I can give you all these slides, right? Again, you see, somebody in this particular patient, diabetes with one or more risk factors less than 70. There is only one group of people in diabetes where you keep it less than 100, which is diabetes with no risk factors, right? No hypertension, no obesity, no dyslipidemia, no smoking, nothing. Only diabetes, less than 40 years of age. LDL goal is less than 100. But diabetes with any other risk factor, in this particular case, each case, she had dyslipidemia. So the goal for this particular patient is less than 70. What should be the blood pressure again? What should be the blood pressure? Yes, less than 150-90, less than 140-90, less than 130-90, less than 130-80, less than 120-80. What should be the goal? Somebody writes less than 140-90. Okay, great. 130-80. So again, this lady doesn't have complications. She doesn't have, we have not talked about any macrovascular disease. We are not talking about any complications that she have. So again, diabetes without complications, the goal of blood pressure should be less than 140-90. Diabetes with heart attacks, or diabetes with heart failure or stroke, or diabetes with peripheral vascular disease, you can always go with a lower blood pressure, right? So in this particular lady, 140-90. So again, diabetes, patients with diabetes, goal of blood pressure less than 140-90. When you have high risk or you have got cardiovascular disease or complications, go with 130-80. And again, we have already done this. Glycemic management, blood pressure management, lipid management, agents with benefit to kidney and heart. DPP-4 inhibitors, again, very good second line agents after metformin. And again, in those who cannot tolerate metformin, you can give it as first line. So twice daily dosing, A1C reduction 1%, weight neutral, no hypoglycemia, cost effective, cardiovascular safe, renal safe. Come on to the last case. This is the last case. It's very beautiful.